Well, with a lifetime of grappling repetitions, here he is back in the big show here tonight and would appear to have a lot of advantages when it comes to the grappling game.
Yeah, the moment he gets a hold of you, it is crazy how strong this man is. When he was in the fighter meeting with John, we looked at his hands and they all beat up. Oh, a lifetime of just grabbing on that gi, slamming guys to the ground, wrestling, pulling. It's unreal to watch him manipulate and maneuver guys to get them to the floor. He is a master in this style of fighting, and he's used it to start off great in the UFC.
He's almost like a professional climber, too, when it comes to the grip strength and the exercises he does to maintain that grip strength. I'm glad I'm not fighting today. Triple C, Henry Cejudo, is ready to engage him again. The Sugar Show live and in color. Sean O'Malley back on the proven ground here tonight. And what else can you say about what he did against Abu Dhabi? Close fight against Piotr Jan, but that really served to put him on this championship trajectory.
Boy, you gotta stand out and take note when you fight someone like that. So close. Even if he had lost, you had to give him his respect. But ultimately, he got the decision. This guy is a great striker. The one area where we have not seen him tested is in the grappling. Tonight, he will have to rely on that if he wants to get another victory in what has been a fast-paced ascent up the bantamweight rankings.
And he is a willing grappler. We've seen him compete in Quintet Ultra, Augusto Tanquinho Mendez, UFC veteran there firmly in his corner. But you're right, we haven't necessarily seen Sean O'Malley tested in that realm as yet. The tape for this bantamweight fight. All right, now for the particulars inside the octagon of Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It's time! Five rounds of the UFC bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, presenting the former UFC flyweight champion of the world and the former UFC featherweight champion, Henry Triple C Cejudo. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner, presenting the former UFC featherweight champion, Sugar Sean O'Malley.
Herb Dean, third man in the octagon tonight. Well, never any great mystery when Sean O'Malley's in the octagon. The lettuce on the afro is flowing. As for the fight, though, O'Malley's been a pretty fast starter in the UFC. Let's see if he can continue that trend here tonight. All right, early round action here, and the kickboxer's not going to win the fight by stuffing one takedown, but so far so good as far as his takedown defense is concerned.
It's a great start, right, because it's something to build off of, but he has to truly understand he cannot be content with only stopping one. He's got to recognize that he's got to stop multiple over the course of this fight.
Nice 1-2 there. Oh, now gets an underhook to get a more dominant position.
He lands a big knee to the body. Wow.
About the judo toss there. It's not as easy as it looks, I can assure you.
Oh, you gotta be careful there, yep.
Oh, O'Malley getting work from the top here. These ground and pound strikes, very effective. Let's see if he tries to work his way back to his feet.
Short elbow, short elbow.
good job to land these strikes from top position. Again, not much defense there. Another ground strike gets through. Man, this is some serious ground and pound. He's trying to put this dude's head, like, through the canvas.
He's one of the better ground and pound fighters we have in the entire UFC, and you're seeing why. Yes, smart adjustment. Yep. Getting him out here.
2 minutes have expired off the round one clock here. Relentless pressure from the top by the ever-improved Henry Cejudo. All right, side control now.
It's work. I stand it up. It's work.
Inside control, you got a ton of options. He goes knees on belly. He's postured up. He's landed big ground and pound. He has to move on the bottom or the fight's going to get stopped. Massive shot from the top.
Oh, staying busy from top position. He lands another ground strike there. Outstanding pressure from top position here by Cejudo. Remain in the round. All right, just as we saw a few seconds ago, he finds the home for another ground and pound strike.
Beautiful punch lands there from inside the guard.
All right, so now blood is a factor. You see that he has been opened up in that eye area.
Yeah, he's got hit in the eye and now there's a cut. But it's nothing to worry about too much now. But he's got to be very careful.
All right, so he's got the body locked down here, DC, or so it appears. This is not a guy you want anywhere near your back. Cejudo's right back to the full mount here.
Oh, he got to a spot.
Postures up now and lands a vicious head strike. Well, this is a tough fighter to buck off. Very good pressure and work here by the ever-improved Henry Cejudo. Moving his head on the ground here, avoiding a lot of these big shots. Gonna try to take his opponents back here, and he does. While working pretty effectively from the top here, nice ground and pound by Cejudo. And there it is, another strike on the ground, gets through. Cejudo's back in full mount. And again, dealing with that cut around his eye, gotta be careful.
He's gotta shore up the defense, because if he keeps getting hit there, it's only gonna continue to get worse.
O'Malley's in half guard. And busy as he looks to improve position here. Final seconds of round one. Maximizing his shots here on the ground. Oh, and there's the horn at the end of the round. So the fighter was really caught in the submission there just as the horn sounded. Safe to say he was saved by the bell there. So back to the stools they go. 60 seconds to recover here. We're going to fight on, ladies and gentlemen. Another round coming up. All right, let's get you some pictures from that previous round, DC. A lot of good work with the ground and pound strike.
Yeah, he was able to control posture, get himself postured up, land big ground and pound as he ended the round. What a great finish to a fantastic round.
Ready. Ready.
Go. Second round here. All right, here we go with our next round. And thankfully for his opponent, it begins on the feet because his face was... Maybe time to get the bonus checks ready.
I mean, this fight is about done. He's got him hurt very bad. Now we have to find one more strike to end the night.
So pretty good recovery by the opponent after getting stunned pretty good. Got to capitalize on those opportunities.
I mean, you can't waste these opportunities. You don't get them as often as you'd like. So if you get a guy hurt, you got to find a way to finish the fight.
really making good use of his reach advantage as he lands the straight punch there.
Another straight left. It's so clear that the guy that's going forward is the guy that's successful.
Job there raising the guard to protect the eye with that block. You can't allow that cut to get worse as this fight continues.
It got defended, but it will give Henry the idea that takedown may be coming.
Right hand is there over the top. Well, oh, huge shot finds the target there.
Great shot lands. Now he's got to go find that follow-up attempt. The kill shot is what they call it to go and end the fight. Gets in close and gets that single collar tie locked in tight.
Could be the beginning of the end here.
Oh, look at that. Go get him.
Under 3 minutes here to go round two. Both fighters starting to open up a little bit.
Nice high guard. Shows great defense.
Back to the single.
Look at that. Recognize he's about to lose position.
Oh, nice transition there by Henry Cejudo. You got to think Santino DeFranco in the corner likes that. Cejudo putting it all together tonight. Oh, he escapes.
He got out. Wow, that is great submission defense.
Well, he has really picked up the pace. Continues to sway with every huge shot being landed. Back and forth we go.
Landed some nasty strikes. He ate that kick. He took that whole kick, yep.
Cejudo's torso, specifically that right side, has absorbed a lot of damage tonight. And here comes the purple, the black, and blue. A definite bruise started to form on that right side.
He loaded up there on that kick.
Stuffs that takedown attempt without issue. 90 seconds to go in round two. Trying to hammer that lead leg. Also, the title fighter lands a knee yet again. Yet another strike targeting that already bruised area on the side of his body.
Just mixing everything up there. Finding his target, using his punches, his kicks, and everything else to try to do damage to his opponent's body. I love this game plan.
Under a minute now to go round two.
Nice pass.
Man, that is loud. Another strike lands for the kickboxer. He really found that flow state pretty early in this fight, and he hasn't looked back.
He found it really early. And when this guy gets into his groove, he is hell on wheels. And right now he is showing why he is such a high-level, high-regarded kickboxer. He is outclassing this guy. Oh, right into mount. This is where he wants to be.
Well, this is not football. Targeting is legal, and he is going at that cut, which is getting worse with every passing ground strike. Final seconds here. Oh, outstanding combination of ground and pound punches here by Cejudo. All right, round three coming up next. All right, so there's the horn. The round is over. He stunned his opponent multiple times in that round. A huge round from Cejudo.
The end of that round. He is not going to recover, okay? I want you to go out there this round, and I want you to get up.
All right, so there's the end of the round. He stayed committed to doing damage upstairs and landed a seminal blow in that round.
It was accumulation of those strikes. He kept hitting him over and over to the head. Eventually, he found the one that really did damage his opponent.
You ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. Cejudo's strike attempt there is blocked. Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
He gets it.
We'll see if he tries to change levels here. Trips his opponent with the ankle pick.
An ankle pick takedown. We're so used to seeing singles, doubles, high crotches. When an ankle pick is hit, you applaud the guy doing the technique. There it is. Now he's going to mount.
Well, the ground and pound has been on point tonight. Good work here by Cejudo. Well, this is absolutely the hurt business. It's hard to see which party is more injured, but I think both fighters have been really effective with their strikes in this one. Oh, heavy shots raining down.
He's doing a really good job putting himself in position.
And how much more can he take? Dean steps in. What a fight! So no judges needed tonight as he pounds him out for the TKO. I'm hoping I get an invite to the after. Well, he's going to enjoy watching this one back. Let's take a look at the replay of the knockout just a moment ago.
It was right hand after right hand after right hand. Finally, he found the one that hit the exact sweet spot that ended his opponent's night.
We go to Bruce Buffer for the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Deans called a stop to this contest at 1 minute, 13 seconds of round number three. Declaring the winner by TKO, Henry Triple C Cejudo!
Well, you heard it there from Bruce Buffer. Message sent. Henry Cejudo, the Olympic gold medalist, your winner tonight by TKO.
Henry Cejudo really did emphasize.